Hi, I'm Justin Kelly, writer and director of King Cobra. Well, yeah, it's a very wild, scandalous story, and I read about it online while researching my first film, I Am Michael. I can't remember how I stumbled upon it, but I had that same response that I had with I Am Michael, which was you read about this wild event and just ask yourself, how did this happen? So in this case, how did a gay pornographer get murdered over his star's contract? It's a very extreme move. So the more I read about the story and learned about the characters, the more fascinating the entire idea of making this into a film became. And yeah, I definitely thought it would be very difficult to get off the ground because it's hard to get independent films made, let alone one about a gay character, let alone gay sex. But it's just something where I think once I wrote the script, from cast to financiers, everyone kind of jumped on board very quickly because I think they just got that it was, a film that's not just about gay porn or gay sex. It's about these really, interesting characters, and it's a kind of like wild ride, and it's entertaining, and I hope people agree when they see it. A lot of films, I mean, I'm really inspired by a lot of like dark films and dark filmmakers like Michael Haneke, but also, you know, kind of light, colorful work of like, say, Almodovar. And I didn't go into this trying to blend, you know, dark and light in that kind of way, but it just felt, you know, early drafts of the script that were a bit more dramatic and that were trying to take the story or take itself more seriously just didn't feel like it was working. And the more I kind of like had these characters become an extension of their, you know, of their gay porn monikers or of like the kind of stilted porn dialogue, when I brought that into their real, you know, into the real world, into their real world, the script just became more and more and more interesting. And then on set, that kind of became amplified. So, you know, when the first reviews came out of Tribeca and people were throwing around dark comedy, I was a bit thrown off, to be honest. I thought, oh, I didn't think I made a dark comedy. But now I kind of, you know, I get it. It's not, you know, not insulted by it. But yeah, it's a, you know, drama with some dark comedic elements. And it just, I know it organically became that way. This is a short answer.